Welcome to the Ivan Yaragin Sports Palace here in Krasnoyarsk, Russia, and the 29th Winter Universiad. And welcome to the curling gold medal match in the women's event. The conditions are very good, as they have been throughout the tournament. The ice is running well, and we are on sheet D for this match between Sweden, the top seeds, and Korea, who have surprised a few this week, but they are sleeping giants. I'm Karen Bashir, and joining me in the commentary box, the coach of the Czech program, Brad Askew. Brad, what do you say about what we're about to see?
Well, we're looking forward to a really great game here. Sweden have had a great round robin. Came up through the ranks, lost a game to the Czechs right in the beginning, I think a bit of nerves, and then went straight through. So Korea's, they've got a good record against. These teams have been together before. I think Korea was the last winners against Team Rana, but this is going to be a great final. We predicted Sweden right from the beginning to be sitting in this gold medal game, but we weren't quite sure if it was going to be against Russia or Korea, so here they are.
Well, throughout the tournament, these guys have been busy, coming out before every session with the bagpipes. A familiar feel for those who know their curling.
You know that you're at a top international competition when you hear the squirrel of the bagpipes. There's nowhere around the world, from Canada to China to wherever we host top events. This competition always starts, and the medal sessions certainly always start with the sound of the bagpipes.
Oh, Isabella Rana, 21 years old, from Vällingby, northwest of Stockholm, studying at Stockholm University. It's the skip for the Swedish team. The Koreans now with their skip, Kim Min-ji. You can see that she's playing this one pretty tight to the line. A rock not curling quite as much. And what's the weight like on this?
It's just not finishing as much. It's just rolled a little bit to the outside. Sweden will be able to use that, come down with really gentle weight, tap that, and come underneath. That should pass the back one for 2 points.
Well, that is what Rana is going after. Last stone of the first end. She has the hammer.
No.
And after throwing two heavy rocks.
It's moving now. They've got to get it past that top guard. Good sweep. Great shot. Beautiful weight, beautiful line. Really good sweeping.
Yep, so they'll look to, as they call it, blank the end here. No score, but they retain the hammer going into the third end. Kim Min-ji, the skip for the Koreans. A bit of an anxious look on her face then as she released that.
They've got to hold this stone so it doesn't roll out of play. That's why the anxious look. Oh, no, is it or isn't it? Let's have a look. maybe from the overhead camera we can get a better look. That looks like it's got the momentum. No, it's I'd say that's out. Yeah.
Well, they started the sweep early in this one.
Nice and close to the guard. This looks like a great shot. It's about position now. Great throw. Yep, that's what they wanted.
Well, here we go. Last stone of the second end. The sweepers are staying mainly off this one. Looking to draw between the guards.
They're getting ready to sweep. This looks heavy. I think you're in the back eight with this one. Yep.
It's gone through and it's a steal for the Swedes. A single point when they don't have the hammer and now a big advantage to Sweden and we're just through two ends.
So if they can maintain this, Korea's guaranteed a two. They need to split the house. These stones have got to be level. They don't want to give Sweden another chance to remove both. So they've got to get this directly across on the other side of the rings from the yellow that's sitting there right now.
So a delicate accuracy-based shot here?
Absolutely. This is down to the sweepers. They know their job and they must get this stone out of a double position, as flat with the other one as they can, so there's no shot.
So Kim Min-ji does her job, adds the weight for to the rock. It's coming down the center line. Just starting to turn here. The sweepers have been asked to do nothing just yet. The weight on this. Well, perhaps a bit heavier than she would have wanted.
Yeah, that's a little deeper. The double angle's there if she can. No, she's just going to remove this. Keep them to two. If this was a fun training game, she'd probably go for it. But as it stands, she's just going to play safe, make sure they can get a maximum of two. Still keep Sweden 1 point ahead on the board.
Rana out of the hack. Releases just ahead of the hog line. Wants this to start to turn inwards.
Okay, good throw. Yep, so now Korea's just got a nose hit to this end. It's worked out well for them. Didn't start out well, but it's shaped up for them to score two.
And these athletes are trying to put the stones with these accuracy shots onto the head of a pin.
Nice shot.
Well, Isabella Rana is very conscious that the Koreans are very good. And she said just before the match that they feel they need to step up their game and play their very best to beat Korea. That they are going to try and make their shots. And if you look at the percentages for Rana, the Swedish skip, they're pretty good. 100% on draws.
Sweepers are really working this one. That's why.
Oh, just clipped the guard on the way through. That wasn't the plan. And still, that yellow rock is the closest to the button. It is the scoring rock.
So Korea are just going to come down with a nice controlled weight, push this red stone out to the side and roll over, just like the skip's showing you there. Lied to. Depending on where this ends up, this just gives Sweden a draw for 1 point for this end. So Korea's done their job.
Kim Min-ji in discussion with Kim Hyerin. skip throwing from the hack. The vice in the house.
They need to get a really good stone position here. If they catch this thin roll out, or if they catch that top guard, Sweden are on for two or three.
Pressure on. That's the last stone for the Koreans. The hammer is with Sweden in this end. Instructed to stay off it initially, and now they start the sweep.
That's a great shot. It's exactly what they wanted.
Yeah, clip the guard on the way through here. So trying to come through down the middle line, breaking from right to left as we look at this one coming down the ice in between the guards. This for a single point in the fourth end of the gold medal match. Clears the guards. Misses the top one and rests up. Job done there by Isabella Rana, getting a single point. Korea, though, will be quite happy that it's just the one. So just a draw to the center here then, Brad. Just a nice simple one in between those two Korean rocks.
I think she'll be looking to hit and roll into the center here. Cut them down. They've only got one stone left, and if she removes this one, the maximum they can get is two. But if they roll underneath, she's going to have a tough shot. So I think she's going to come off this and roll to the center behind those guards.
Well, the weight suggests you're right. Coming down the ice, what's the line like and what's the contact like?
Okay, it's a miss hit. She really wanted to roll underneath there.
Critical shot here for the Koreans, trailing 4-2 at the moment. Starting to bite now, but what's the weight like? Oh, that is a disastrous shot for Korea.
That is the last shot you wanted going into the half game break. That's really going to hurt. The Swedes are really pumped up over that one. They know that that really has swung the momentum of the game. Big, big mistake from Korea.
So had to blank the sixth. Here Sweden in the box seat in the seventh. They seem happy with this, and that is why.
Great shot. Sweden are a great hitting team. Great hitting team. If Korea don't get something safe, then Sweden are just going to go for it. And they're not scared to play doubles, run backs. Shots that used to be more the men's side of the game, and the women now, fearless, just play the same shot.
Well, under pressure now, Kim Min-ji has to play a delicate accuracy shot here. She's looking to come between the two red rocks at the top of the house.
She's going to come through those two reds and hit this one on the nose, but she's got to be really careful. She catches one of the top ones, or she hits too thin and rolls on this one and it's another steal for Sweden, then I'm afraid that's the game. They'll give themselves an impossible task.
Sweeping hard on the right as we look down on it. Oh, she's clipped the front rock.
She's done it, yeah.
And is that going to be two?
That's two.
A steal of two for the Swedes. Kim Hyerin, the third for Korea, releases her last stone of the eighth end and actually could well be her last stone here at the Winter Universiade. If they can't do something about this strong Swedish team, I suspect Korea will concede. But it's a gold medal match, so who knows?
Okay, once again, it's the same story. Sweden can fully see that. This will be gone in a matter of 60 seconds.
Isabella Rana, the skip, will be in the hack now. And as you can see, they are going to aim at that rock. They won't, as Brad has been saying throughout this end, be worried about hitting their own rock. Although it's so out in the open, they could hit it and still be on for three.
The best shot here would be if she takes the yellow stone, her own stone off the back, and sits side by side. So there's no way around behind to the button.
Sweeping hard early on this one.
Great shot.
Well, look at that. Three in a line there. Rana, a little wry smile on her face.
She's had a great week. This has been her trademark the whole week, is this hitting. So accurate. And the team can build so much confidence from that, because they know whatever happens in the end, their skip will step down and sort it out.
Kind of like having, knowing that you've got the best goalkeeper in the world.
It certainly is. This, so much of curling depends the team's confidence on their skip. If it gets messy and there's a room to draw to the button, it's the skip's job to step up, throw that stone to the button, take 1 point and walk away, limit the damage. And so much of this is confidence in your skip, knowing that they can step up and get you out of a mess if things have gone wrong. Okay, we're going to get a timeout here now from the Koreans. They're going to bring their coach down to get as much advice as they can. Do they hit? Do they draw? Unfortunately, he's coming down to a pretty desperate situation.
Yeah, interesting that the teams get some travel time for the coach to come down from the technical area, plus the thinking time or the timeout time. Is that because people were taking inordinately amount, a long amount of time for the coaches to get down from the box?
They do change the rules every once in a while, but at the moment what used to happen is the coach traveled down and as soon as they spoke to the first person on the team, the 1 minute talking time started. They've changed the rule now that if you get down without running, you have to maintain a walking pace. If you don't, then the time, the 1 minute talking time starts immediately because coaches were jumping over barriers and things to try to get there faster.
to buy some extra time.
So now you've got the whole travel time plus 1 minute. It's how you use it. So a nice brisk trot down without running gives you maximum time. In the old days when you had travel time and you tried to stroll as slowly as possible to give your team as much time and time your arrival to the team at exactly the 1 minute. So what happens is the umpires before the competition will get up out of a coach bench, they'll walk down to the house at the near side, check and see how long that took, give you a little bit of grace time to get your jacket off. Then they do the same thing for the opposite end and they announce at the pre-event meeting how long the coaches have got to travel to the near end and to the far end. You cannot enter the field of play with your warm over jacket on, so you must take your coat off and come down matching your team. So you need a few seconds to take that jacket off and then walk down.
Well, the timeout's done here. A decision has been made. Coach Lee Sun-jun has returned to his seat.
In round robin play, there's a mandatory six ends, but in the playoffs, there's a mandatory eight ends. So this is the eighth end of the game.
Yeah, of a possible 10, but what Brad's alluding to is a concession could be the call here. They've gone for a hit. They've cleared out the Swedish stones, all bar one. And let's see who's sitting closest to the button. I think that is just Korea.
Sweden will just come down and hit this one on the nose. little roll would be nice to not leave Korea a double and a shot for two. So I think she's going to hit. I can't see from the brush whether she wants to roll toward her stone or away. I don't know what weight she's called. But to either roll away from them and keep the two red stones apart or roll and sit right on top of it.
Well, Isabella Rana with her last stone, Sweden's last stone. Korea have the hammer. And Korea, well, they need a break. They need a bit of luck. Rana doesn't look like she's going to be offering them anything here.
Yeah, the angle's there, but it's really risky. They really have no choice. They're sitting third shot, which means both red stones have to go for them to score two.
So is she going to draw for the button here just to save the one?
No, I think they're looking at the angle here and what they have to come off. They want to hit the top red thin enough to redirect onto the back red and score two. You can see the smiles in the background. They know how tough this shot is. Sweden, they've left them a really... You can see now that the Korean skip is checking the angle. She's going to come off that center stone onto the back one.
So she's trying to hit the red stone in the white that the brush is on at the moment, exactly where the brush
pretty
is, in fact.
There, yes.
And then roll onto the red behind their own yellow to knock both of them out of the way. This is a big shot for Korea. You fancy if they get it, they won't go for the concession. This really is to stay in this gold medal match. Good shot, but they've knocked their own rock out. Too much of a connection for the Koreans, and they have conceded the gold medal match. And Sweden do take it. Korea got just a single point in the eighth end. And that took them to 8-3, trailing by five with two to go. The gold medal is Sweden's. Sjöberg, Duval, Wallin and Rana on top of the podium here in Krasnoyarsk at the 2019 Winter Universiade.